Hey guys, welcome back to the social network app. We are going to be starting our project setup today, which shouldn't hopefully take too long. I expect this will be a fairly short video. This is essentially going on you having an environment already sort of set up, a local environment. Full disclosure, this project was originally built with XAMPP, but when I upgraded to Composer 2, for some reason, I guess the PHP version, between all the changes with Laravel, the PHP version with XAMPP, the version that I was using it, along with the Composer 2 update, just XAMPP just decided not to work. So the one that I have in the first episode that we walked through yesterday, that was built in a Laravel Homestead environment. Now, if we have an issue, it should be okay now. I haven't tested it. So if we run into an issue with XAMPP again, what I'll do is I'll walk us through installing Homestead into this project so that we can continue on without a hassle. I really like XAMPP. It's much more lightweight, but there are a lot more things that I can do with the Homestead environment. However, we won't need all of the things that Homestead is providing. If you are building your app already on Homestead, then by all means go ahead and use it. It doesn't really matter. It just matters for me because I need to make sure that it works going forward. Make sure that it works properly. And like I said, if it doesn't, then I'll just change the environment. I'll do that with you step by step so that we can all be on the same page, or at least you can see how it's done. If yours is working fine, you do not have to do it. Let's just keep our fingers crossed that all of it works. Okay, so that's my little disclaimer. Okay, so now since we're going to be using XAMPP, well, you could do this with Homestead too, but there are two ways to use Composer. You can either use this command right here, which will do the same thing. But if you have Composer and the Laravel installer installed globally, then what you can do is what I'm going to do is use this command right here. This is how you would get the installer globally. This command right here, this whole command. And this one is the one that we're going to be using. And I'm going to show you how to do it with Jetstream, the Jetstream flag as well, to just kind of do the whole install at once. Okay, so our project is going to be, or the first command is Laravel new, and then we're going to call it social, I think I named it network demo, and then we're going to put the flag of Jet. What this command is going to do is install all of Jetstream and configure everything correctly how we need it to be done for using Inertia. So you press enter. And then it's going to bring up this page. Now, again, I said we're going to be using Inertia, so we press 1, enter. Will your application use Teams? And we're going to go with no. We're not going to be creating Teams or any sort of admin backend. And then you press enter. Okay, so now that it's started, what I'm going to do is pause the video and let this run, and I'll see you on the other side of this. Okay, now that it's finished installing, let's go ahead and cd into the folder. So to do that, you can just press arrow up, can get rid of this. You can get rid of this and type cd space, and that'll take us to the directory. Okay, great. So now you would want to open this up in your favorite code editor. I'm going to be using Visual Studio Code, so the command I type is code space period enter.
And what that'll do is that'll open the project right up into Visual Studio Code with all our files. Okay, there we go. Okay, now that we are in, let's go ahead and open up a couple of terminals. The first one, I can do one and two. The first one is going to be for our to run our server. So the command is going to be php artisan serve. And the one on the right is going to run our npm run watch. And what this will do is compile down all of our CSS and JavaScript files that we have here. Okay, so while that's doing that, the first thing I want to do is go to our environment file, and I want to change our app name to social network. Okay, the reason I changed that to quotations is because PHP does not like for you to have spaces. It won't recognize it unless you have the quotation marks. The other thing that we need to change in here, it's the database. Now, whatever you name your database, it's fine. I'm just doing this for, you know, our purposes. So that's the database name that I have set up already. This is the username for it, and the password is just blank. There's nothing else there. Okay. So since we have our server running, let's see if there's anything up here just yet. Okay, so we have base table or view not found. Now what that means is that we haven't run our migrations yet. And PHP, I think it was PHP 8 is where it started, where you needed to make sure you run your migrations before you can do anything else. So we'll open up another terminal and we'll go ahead and get that done. So the command for that, it's php artisan migrate. Okay, press enter. Now, if you're curious at all where these migrations are coming from, right over here where you see database, if you open that up, that folder, you'll see another one for migrations. And then this is a list of different migrations that came with the installation. We won't be touching them in this episode, but we will definitely get to them when we start putting in some information. Okay, so that's already done. Now let's see if we still get this error here. Should clear it right up. Okay, so you can see up top, it already says social network. This is the landing page for the app. So the title already says social network. Now, don't worry about this. This is just from testing. I will show you how to change this and make this, if you don't have this yet, when we start doing more fixing of the defaults and setting them up the way we want them. But right now, it's just cached. We don't have it in our app yet, so don't worry about it if you don't see it. So that's done. Now let's take a look at our... This is our database right here, and it's already set up. And as you can see, there's nothing in there just yet because we don't have a user or anything. Okay, so that's done. Now let's take a look at this. We have an error already. Oh, okay, I know what this is. So it essentially compiled correctly. That's fine. But Laravel mix... Now it's conflicting with my Windows because I have notifications turned off, my snore toast notifications. So that Laravel mix pop-up that you would normally get, I've deactivated that on my personal system. How can you fix that? You can go to webpackmix.js and right here just add another line and put disable notifications. There it is. Okay, and that will get rid of that error. So if it doesn't do it here, I think you have to restart it. So we'll go ahead and restart that npm run watch and let that do that again. Okay, so that should be taken care of. Now, next thing that I want to do is I want to pull in another font. I want to have a different font as our default. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead to Google Fonts and I'm going to grab one from there. So Montserrat is the one that I want to use. You click it. And then you go to, I scroll down and usually we'll pick up the, I think it's the regular. Did I go too far? Regular 400. That's the one I click. Select the style. Okay. And then you go up here to this icon up top. Click that. And you'll have a couple of different ways to import it into your project. We're going to be using the add import. So you're going to grab this line of code right here, copy. Okay, and we put this in our resources, CSS, app.css. Now these are the defaults that are pulled in with, that's basically what makes Tailwind work. That's where all the files are for their utility classes. Okay, now to also make this work, what you'll need to do is head down to tailwind.config. And if you have any questions about Tailwind, their documentation is really pretty extensive. It's definitely worth taking a look. If you've not ever written your own CSS, which at this point I think you might have written at least some CSS, it's possible, but I don't know. It's not really like Bootstrap and Vuetify and all Bufy or whatever it is. It's really just putting in the classes themselves into the HTML instead of creating a whole different file for it. But they have these set up in their own default file, if that makes sense. And what I mean by that, it's probably better if I just show you. If you take a look at the public folder, because this is where our compiled CSS and JavaScript are. So if you go to this one, CSS app.css, you'll see that it has all of these styles that are default for Tailwind. They cleared out all of the extra stuff that is built into the HTML. Into the web browsers themselves, and they just cleaned it all up and just gave you a whole bunch of styles to just go ahead and throw into any class that you want. Okay, so that's done, and now we have a correct error. Or sorry, not a correct message of a successful compilation, whatever. Okay, so the other thing you need to do is you need to come down to tailwind.config and add the new font name. So what I'm gonna call this one is primary. You can call it whatever you want, but I would suggest definitely calling it something that is sort of generic, but that makes sense to you. So it's primary colon, you open up some brackets, and then the single quotes, and then just type in the name of the Montserrat of the font name. Okay, so that one's done. That should compile, and then if we go ahead and take a look, we'll see it might not look all that different here, just because it's in the same family, the Sans family. So let's take a look at our inspect tools and see if it shows up there. If it shows up there, then we're good. It'll show up for everywhere. But they're very similar fonts. Okay, so look under the elements tab and in the body tag. Oh, we haven't changed it yet, sorry. Okay, so to change that, you can go to resources, views. Let me scroll up a little bit. Resources, views, app.blade.php, and you're going to change this to primary, which is what we named our new font. You even name it font, you know, Montserrat or whatever your file name is, whatever is easiest for you to remember. But I would suggest doing something more generic like Montserrat. I'm sorry, like primary or secondary or whatever. But that's just how I do it. So just a suggestion. Okay. So now you can see in the body class, the font has changed now to primary. And if you click it and take a look down here, the class name is now the font family. It's Montserrat. Okay. I think I'm going to leave it here, and then we will start fleshing out some of these pages in the next episode, and adding in some more defaults. If you have any questions or comments, go ahead and drop them down, and I'll try to get to them as quickly as possible. I'm not going to be able to do these videos every day. I'm going to try to, but maybe every other day, every couple of days or so, because they do take a while. Please like and subscribe if it was helpful. Great. If it wasn't, I'm sorry, and I will try to do better. But have a great day, and I'll see you guys next episode. Thanks.